Will you be avoiding the political discussion at this holiday's dinner table? Hey, everybody, I'm Chad Hasty, host of the Chad Hasty Show, which airs weekday mornings 8:30 to 11 on NewsTalk 95.1 FM, 790 AM KFYO, and you can listen online at KFYO.com. And now with your Alexa-enabled devices, the Echo Dot, the Echo, and the Echo Show, you can actually enable the KFYO skill, and you can listen to KFYO over the Echo devices. So according to a Reuters poll, one in three U.S. adults will avoid political discussion during Thanksgiving and Christmas. Nearly one-third of all U.S. adults, according to the story here, will avoid political conversations when they see family and friends over the holidays. About half say they expect not to discuss politics at all. The November 8th through 13th poll found that a majority of Americans consider politics to be among their least favorite topics to discuss in mixed company over the holidays. People appear to be more interested in talking about religion or even their personal finances with cousins, in-laws, than discussing the hot-button issues such as tax cuts, Obamacare, and the Russia investigation. Poll respondents say they learned to bite their tongues after years of dinnertime squabbles over Barack Obama and then his successor, Donald Trump. Quote, if you bring up Trump or something, you'll get a look from one side of the table, said Adrian Bell, 77-year-old Trump supporter from Illinois. It's like, let's change the subject. Bill said her family learned this new holiday etiquette after a particularly stressful Thanksgiving back in 08 when Obama had just been elected to his first term. Bill's niece called her a bigot for not supporting President Obama at the time. Well, I guess a lot of families will be avoiding the issue of politics, and maybe that's smart for a lot of people, especially if you have family members with, you know, some diehard opinions on President Trump and the Democratic Party, the Republican Party, tax cuts, Obamacare, Russia, etc. It's probably smart to avoid all of that unless, you know, you want to have somebody throw a turkey leg at you, which may be delicious, so you want to think about that for a little bit. But don't throw any pie, because pie being thrown is bad and can only make mom mad. You got to remember that. So if you are going to get into a political discussion, here are a few tips to take into account when getting into a political discussion at the family table. Put all sharp objects away, okay? That's key. You want to avoid all sharp objects. So put the forks away, put the knives away. Spoons are okay unless your family gets, like, really rough. Then you want to avoid the spoons as well. Put the good china away, okay? Now, I know china's going to come up at some point. Hey, that's very nice china. Someone will say, hey, you know what, I don't, China, they're beating America at everything. They've got nicer plates. Look at it. It's terrible for America. Put the china away. You don't want any china being thrown out. Again, that's going to make mom upset if you break any of the china. Put the crystal away too. Basically, anything that's expensive, put it away before you discuss politics. Finally, go ahead and discuss politics. Have a good time with it. Don't get too wrapped up. Listen, you know your family members. You know your family members and your friends who are impossible to move when it comes to, I don't know, gun control. When it comes to the issues of guns, you know, like personally, if I've got friends out there who I know are just anti-gun, why bother? Especially around the holidays. Why bother even talking to them or trying to move them? You could talk about it, but why bother trying to convince them of different things? Same thing with Trump. Trump, either love the guy or you hate the guy. There's really no in-between when it comes to President Trump. So talk about what he's doing. Talk about policy. Listen, there are serious issues going on in the country, serious issues when it comes to tax reform, when it comes to the Second Amendment, when it comes to the First Amendment, when it comes to a lot of different things in this nation, when it comes to health care, a lot of important things that are going on. It's okay to talk about it. It's okay to even debate it, but don't end up stabbing each other or breaking mom's crystal, because, again, she'll be very, very upset with you. So make mom happy. Don't piss her off, especially when it comes to Thanksgiving and Christmas. You want to make mama happy. Tune in to the Chad Hasty Show weekday mornings, 8:30 to 11 a.m. Central Time. News Talk 95.1 FM and 790 AM KFYO. Have a happy Thanksgiving. And, well, we'll be back afterwards.